come back again. You hear with some old Pete at Flavor Fest.
Yeah.
Chillin', man.
You know what it is.
Appreciate you taking the time for me. Just a couple easy questions. How did you get into doing all your problems?
Man, as far as rapping, man, I mean, something's always been a part of me. I've been doing it all my life. You know what I mean? So it wasn't really hard for me. My life changed. It changed for you. So it's like something that happened.
How long have you been doing it for?
Focus, man. 8 years. 8 years strong.
How did you go about getting saved? Were you like in church when you were younger?
Nah, it was just, you know, for me, I always knew about God and wasn't the fact that I didn't know what God was. You know what I mean? I had to understand it. My lifestyle, my pattern, my lifestyle didn't match up with what it should have matched up with. So it was just a time when I got out of jail the last time I really thought about my life. Like, man, it gotta be something different. You know what I mean? So my mother invited me to a church service and I was like,
last question I just want to ask, like up and coming cast, you know, casting ain't signed, there's a lot of indie cast out there. Do you have any advice as far as like getting signed to a label, what you would suggest?
Hey, make sure your business is right, but if you can, you can get your grind on and go indie, stay independent if you can. Now, if you need a deal, you know what I'm saying? If you can get a deal too, go ahead and work that situation. But if you don't got to, you know what I'm saying? You can stay indie too. It's all good. I mean, either one, as long as you work hard, no matter if you got a deal or not, don't mean you're going to make it all of a sudden. Like, you're going to blow up. That's a big misconception. You got to work hard no matter what you do. So work hard. That's what I got to tell everybody. Yeah. All
right, y'all. That's OP. Got a few more coming up. Stay tuned.
I'm doing good. Oh yeah, I like that.
Looks like K-Drama is on baby duty.
What's up, y'all? It's Lethal back again. Rantings of a Man Named Lethal at Flavor Fest in Tampa, Florida, 2007. Here with my man Eric Frost. Good.
How you doing, man?
Blessed,
man. Thanks for having me, yo.
Appreciate you taking time.
Definitely.
Got a couple of easy questions.
Yeah, go ahead, man.
I gotta try to stump your brain tonight.
All right. Let's see if you can do it.
All right. So, how'd you get into music? Did you start off with the gospel hip hop or?
You know what? I started off doing what you would call positive rap. You know, just wasn't really rapping Christian or anything like that. Was just rapping. Like, I saved at the young age of 15, and I wanted to use. I was always writing, always freestyling. But when I married my wife, she introduced me to this group by the name of The Cross Movement, as y'all, many of you guys know. And I heard their album, was really inspired by it. And later on that year, I felt the calling to utilize my gift for Christ the same way, you know what I'm saying? So it's been about 6 years now, man. So praise God.
Actually, sounds a lot like my story.
Yeah.
My wife introduced me to it.
She, yeah.
Except for she introduced me to straight gospel, which I wouldn't feel.
Thank God for the wives. You know?
So, how did you get saved? So that was basically how you got saved.
I got saved actually, well, I'm 26 now. I'm kind of like fast forward and rewinded, but I got saved at a sermon, an illustrated sermon called To Hell and Back.
Okay. I've heard that before.
And what it did, man, it just frightened me, man. I had goosebumps. I was, you know, I knew that this place called hell.